can use the library for free. We have broadband internet, so if you have a laptop, feel free to come and search and your research online. The library network for the internet is actually separate from NMC, so if they're down over there, the useful tip is come into the library. Usually the online, our online network is up most of the time. So I have a handout for everyone, but feel free to come into the library. You can pick one up. It has some really good information. I'm going to cover some of it right now. If you're searching for a book, we have our new online catalog, which is at library.nmcnet.edu, that went online earlier this year. So if you're not on campus and you want to know if we have a book or maybe one of your textbooks, you can actually just go online and search our catalog to see what we have in our collection. So there are over 40,000 books that you can borrow. You can borrow up to 10 at a time. We can't give you all 40,000, but so as currently going to take up to 10 items, you can the books for 3 weeks at a time, you can review it once. If you can't make it on the campus, you can also just call up and we'll review it for you. You can also take out the free audio visual, so we have DVDs, VHS, and some CDs that we record. So those are some of our key services. And we have some online databases, and also our hours. I want to go over our hours because we just expanded. So we're actually open from 8 a.m. until 8 p.m. on Wednesdays. So for those who work Wednesday night classes or that want to come in and use the library on Wednesdays, like I said, we are open from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. We're open until 6 p.m. on Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday, Friday, 8 to 5, and Saturday, 12 to 4. So, and it's really important that we get student feedback on what hours that you need, that you want us to be open, because we are a student-focused organization, and it really makes a big difference. We were open all day Saturday last semester in spring, and not a lot of people were coming in, so, you know, let us know what's the best time for you, and, you know, we had over 9,000 visitors to the library last month alone, so we're definitely getting well used, and like I said, I was great to see some of your familiar faces, and I hope to see the rest of you in the library soon. Thank you. Any questions, please? I know Leo has one. Leo has a question.
So is it possible for the library to extend or change its opening schedule or closing schedule?
Especially by request for classes. We usually have closed at 6 p.m. and we've extended the hours to close at 8 on Wednesdays. So our hours are kind of under review. We're offering more evening classes now. So that's why we're looking at expanding more into the evening.
Yeah, I would be very glad to come to the library at night. And I would even volunteer to do the library service if really it's possible for, you know, the library can actually expand closing time. Because I appreciate that. I love reading at night with nobody actually around in the daytime. Including me, I'm more likely to chat in the library than studying, but nighttime would be great. Yeah. So I really appreciate if library would ever expand the service to nighttime.
Yeah, it's definitely a planning phase right now, and we're gathering in the other sides. I appreciate your feedback.
Sir, do you have a suggestion for how late at night? 10 p.m. is a suggestion.
I volunteered for 10.
10 p.m. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All right. No, what I wanted to ask, and just thinking about what question can benefit everyone, is if you're new to the island, since you're the information expert, where can they obtain information about the culture and history of the Northern Mariana Islands and its people?
Well, in the library, we do have a lot of books on the CMI in Taiwan. A lot of those you can actually borrow. Some of them are in our reference collection, so you only can use those within the library. We have an expanded volume all on the Marianas in Micronesia. We also have the CMI archives that's located at the college, and they're open from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday. And essentially, it's a government archives. There's a lot of information, including like annual business reports, all kinds of, just pretty much everything, all kinds of information on the culture, on land, on listening to my audience on hand. So that all those resources in the archives, you can only use in the archives, but if you're especially looking at doing some really intensive research, that's a really good place to go. Otherwise, come into the library, ask one of the staff, I'll probably be there, or one of my staff will be there at the desk, and we can point you in the right direction and show you which books on the history of Saipan and some things on the culture. And like I said, you borrow a couple of times for 3 weeks. So that will get you a really good start as far as doing some background research on Saipan and see them out there. Another thing I just want to point out is if you have your student ID, that's actually your library card. So it's important that you get your NMC ID, and anytime you're coming to the library to borrow something, just bring your ID, and that's also your library.
Matt, I have a question regarding the CMI archives. I think I read something where they're digitizing a lot of that information. How's that process proceeding?
We recently got a $20,000 grant from the government, and it's mainly to get a lot of our newspapers microfilmed. They're taking up a lot of space, the air conditioning. There's a lot of issues going on with the number of older newspapers, which are very important for the archives, but we just don't have the space to put them. So essentially, we're going to be working together with the Library of Congress and get some of them, and probably with the University of Hawaii. And that project should be finished by sometime next year. So it probably won't start until the beginning of next year. And we finished by next September. So that's the area that we're doing. And we also work this actually information. We're collaborating with the public library on another large grant to a federal organization. And if we did that, then we'll